All right, welcome back inside our proactive newsroom. And joining me now is Alexander Woodyer-Sherron. She is the CEO of Empress Royalty. And Alexander, it's great to have you back again. How are you?
I'm doing really well, Steve. It's great to be back chatting with you again.
Yeah, lots of stuff to talk about. First off, I wanted to ask you about this $50 million credit facility. Can you talk a bit more about that? And very good for the company, obviously.
Yeah, thank you. Now, in late December, we executed the $15 million accordion credit facility with Nabari. And this, we've drawn down $4.5 million of that to date. And we've deployed some of that capital into Serra Antipite. So with that, we put $2.5 million into Serra Antipite, completing for a full $10 million gold stream. And that's where we get 4.5% of the gold production up to 11,000 ounces, and it drops down to 1% life of mine stream. So we're very excited to have completed that transaction.
You also made a bit more of an investment on the Manica project in Mozambique. Tell me a bit about that one.
Yeah, so we had originally deployed $2 million into that investment. We've increased that by an additional $1 million. So that gives us 3.375% royalty on the project. So very excited to be increasing that and increasing our revenues up to $1.5 million US a year when that project gets into production. Right now it's in construction and they expect to be in production later this quarter, or early next quarter.
Okay. Obviously we're into 2022 now, so there's lots of things coming up for the company this year. Tell me a bit about what this year is holding for Empress Royalty.
Yeah, we, you know, with our investments, we've got some near-term catalysts happening. That's with Serra Antipite increasing their production from 750 tons to 1,000 tons per day, which should be happening in the second quarter this year. And then we've got Talawetto, that project coming online. It's about 95% built now, as well as Talay is letting us know. And that should be bringing in revenue into Empress or fully in production, getting to production Q1 this year. And then we'll be getting some great revenue from that. And then the other catalyst office is Manica, with that one coming online. So with these two development assets coming online and with the construction, with the expansion at Serra Antipite, we're projecting over $5 million of revenue this year over the next 3 years with just those investments, about $28 million US. And with this facility that we did with Nabari, we have another $10 million to deploy in investments. So we're actively working on our pipeline and discussions with quite a few management groups. And hopefully I'll be able to come back soon in the next couple of months and share another investment that we're making with some of these great returns.
Yeah, I would imagine that there's a lot of people out there that are looking for capital and companies like yours. Are you getting lots of calls from a lot of different people wondering if you'd like to get involved in their particular project?
Yeah, and we, you know, it is some calls coming through our network, and we're looking at a lot of opportunities in South America and in Africa right now, both public and private companies, and investment size fits within the criteria of what we've got available to us in a Nabari facility. So we are looking at some great opportunities at the moment that'll bring us some great returns. And I mean, our average portfolio IRR right now is about 35%, and so we're sort of, you know, going after some really good investments.
All right. Well, we'll leave it there. It looks, sounds exciting. Means you and I will talk a lot in 2022. Alexander, yes. Thanks so much. Great to see you again.
Great to see you too. Thank you so much, Steve.
All right. There's Alexander Woodyer-Sherron. She is the CEO of Empress Royalty.